right, well, I'm the Great Orbax, and this is Dr. Mike Massa, and we're here today to do yet another example of torque. Now, this version of torque is going to be a little bit more complicated than before, as it will actually utilize both methods of solving for torque that we've seen in the past. So you might want to go back and watch those first two videos yet again.
Okay, here's the problem I put together. We've got a box or a sign that's being rested against a pole here, and we're going to hang it from a couple of ropes. Let me put one rope with tension T1.
Boom, T1.
Let's make that at an angle of 60 degrees.
60!
Second rope on the other side, T2, we'll just keep that
vertical. Pow, T2!
The box is going to have some sort of mass or weight, so we'll put a force of gravity acting at the center of mass.
Straight down!
And then finally, because there is contact here with this post, we'll put a normal force acting horizontally.
What?
Okay. So, okay, all right, it's not rotating anywhere, so we can say, we know that the sum of the torques is going to equal zero. We'll have some forces causing a clockwise, some a counterclockwise rotation. And let's just say that anything that's going to try to rotate counterclockwise we'll call a positive torque. All right, why don't you take us
away? All right, well, the first thing we need to do in order to solve for some of the torques that are involved is to actually pick a pivot point. So I'm going to take a pivot point to be literally right here where it's in contact with the actual surface.
Sure, yeah.
That means that a certain number of forces are going to be trying to rotate it this way. Certain number of forces are potentially going to be trying to rotate it that way. So we'll have our positive and negative torques.
Okay. All right, well, look, why don't you tell me what the torque for the first tension is going to be?
Well, like I mentioned before, this utilizes both methods of solving for the torque. So this first one, T1, will actually look at taking the distance of the force multiplied by the force's perpendicular component.
Okay, and what's that?
The distance there from the pivot point to where that tension acts is 0.4 meters multiplied by the perpendicular component of this tension. So we're just looking at taking T1 times the cosine of 60 degrees.
Okay, and this is going to be, what, a positive torque?
This would cause this entire thing to rotate this way in the direction of positive rotation.
Okay, there we go.
Secondly, let's look at the torque due to T2. If we look at T2, we're actually using that second technique for solving for torque. You look at the full value of that force, you extend a line of action going all the way down parallel with that force, and then we take the perpendicular distance to that line of action. So in this case, from pivot to that line of action is 1 meter. At that point, we take the full value of the force, T2.
Okay. So just like that then?
Exactly.
Okay.
We can also do the same thing with the weight. We take our line of action, we extend it, we make it super wavy and not at all straight like I did just there. And what we do is we take the distance from that pivot to where the weight acts, which in this case is 0.5 meters, just halfway across, and the full value of that weight, or the value W. We don't really know what it is yet, it doesn't matter.
Okay, this is a negative torque though, right?
Right, this weight would actually pull, cause this thing to rotate in this direction, opposite direction as positive, therefore causing a negative rotation.
Okay.
Finally, we're left with the last force. We've got the torque due to the normal force, but in this case, whether we take the perpendicular distance to it or whether we take the perpendicular force, in both cases, the distance from our pivot to where that force acts is zero, giving us a value of zero.
Okay.
In total, you should see that all of these forces, all these torques sum together to give us a value of zero, and we'll use that later to probably solve for any of these unknowns.
Okay. All right, well, let's do this again with a different pivot point then.